he's a total creep, and you absolutely could not change my mind about that. He has moved his show Louder with Crowder from YouTube to Rumble, and he's been facing allegations of abusing his wife and harboring an extremely toxic workplace environment. Now, he's also apparently attempting to put a muzzle on his staff and his former staff. The company is in panic mode, according to some former staffers who spoke with Mediaite, and one of those former staffers said this. The company is clearly in damage control mode. What's bizarre is that Louder with Crowder employees are a bit like a family. Even after people leave, they still remain friends and hang out together. But after the Mediaite article was published, I noticed several current employees quit returning my texts and left group chats. Continues on, one outright told me that they could no longer associate with me or else they would be fired. I could tell they were scared. Now, this isn't the only ex-staffer that Mediaite spoke with, because another ex-staffer had this to say. An employee friend of mine texted me saying they can no longer associate with me, but that it's nothing personal. I asked why and they said they couldn't tell me, but that it's something with work and they could get in serious trouble. Now, the serious trouble, according to a third former show employee, is termination, getting fired, losing their jobs. And in its initial reporting, Mediaite spoke with 5 former show staffers and one source close to Crowder under the condition of anonymity. And we've seen this footage that's playing of him, you know, verbally abusing and berating his wife. I absolutely understand why these people would want to speak under the condition of anonymity. We also saw his public feud with Daily Wire. This is not someone who's afraid to throw people close to him under the bus. Now, these former staffers described the workplace as being ripe with things like bullying, drug use, alarming and unpredictable behavior, and sexual misconduct, which you've probably heard a little bit about in the past. But just a little bit more on that, one former Louder with Crowder employee told Mediaite this. In the moment, we dismissed it as sort of frat boy humor. In hindsight, it's super creepy and felt groomerish. It always felt like childish behavior in the moment that then felt predatory in hindsight. Like he was always testing people's comfort levels with that kind of behavior. Because he was the boss though, and he had no accountability, it just continued to happen. There was no one trusted to complain to. Now, another former employee alleged Crowder habitually exposed himself to other male staffers and handed out prescription pills. Now, I don't know about you, Cenk, but this doesn't necessarily sound like the family values that Crowder loves to preach on his show, but it is kind of in line with things that I've heard about Crowder from other people in the media space.
Yeah, we covered one of these stories before where the former employees were saying that he would constantly send them pictures of his penis, but only to the males. I don't know if you think that's better or worse, that's up to you, or just neutral either way, not a good idea either way. I know I have an opinion on it. He's the boss there.
Right.
I mean, sending pictures of your penis to your employees is mental. Okay, that he should thank his lucky stars that he hasn't been sued to oblivion. And then he apparently did Bible studies where he would talk about how Abraham wanted to stroke dude's thighs. If you say so, Stephen, okay. But look, I'm the fairest man in America, so I get being frustrated about the leaks. But no, you cannot tell your employees who to be friends with and who not to talk to. That's also crazy. But they're in crazy land over there, so maybe that doesn't seem unnormal to them. Look, here, I'll do a prediction, and I don't take any joy in this, but at some point, one of those right wingers is that used to work for him or currently works for him is going to talk to a lawyer, and the lawyer is going to say,
"Right,
you can get a lot of his money." And they're right wingers; they're going to try to get a lot of his money, and apparently, they have some amazing evidence against him. But it's not for me to judge. I'm just telling you what they're saying, Jackson.
Well, and I mean, look, anything I've ever seen of Steven Crowder, he kind of just made a career out of, you know, pushing people's buttons. And eventually that's going to come back to you, especially again, the footage with his wife. And then, as you pointed out, you know, sending his employees pictures of his junk, and but only the guys, you know, because that's not gay, even though he's always, you know, harping on that issue, dressing up like a woman, trying to make fun of it. But, you know, there's nothing to see there. But I also want to point out that Rumble is like where all the streamers go when everyone else has like rejected them. Not to say that you can't have any, you know, I mean, if you're on Rumble, fine. But that's like the number one sign that your career is about on its way out when you get on Rumble, because there's no rules there to the same extent. And most people on there are people like Sneeko or the Andrew Tates or people or the just pearly things, Nick Fuentes. Those are the types of people who hang out on Rumble for the most part. So it's really fitting that Steven Crowder's on his way there. And I suspect that a lot more information is going to come out just about how big of a douchebag this guy really is.
Right. And if I could just, okay, I hate this conspiracy theory that everyone who's a homophobe is actually secretly gay. But when it pertains to Steven Crowder, I mean, this is a man who is on his own show said that he has had to overcome his battles with bisexuality that he faced in college. Okay, I hate that notion, but I think it can be squarely applied to Steven Crowder. But also on top of that, just to the point you were making, Cenk, about being sued. I mean, louder with Crowder, you know, just from seeing, he's done some behind the scenes video that I thought was really silly, but I watched it and he definitely has more than 15 employees. This is someone who could be sued for, you know, a hostile workplace environment. It's gotta be coming. It has to be coming. Someone is gonna cash in on this. One of his former employees.
Yeah, and look, that's between them. And then if they do sue, then they'll have to present evidence. And then we'll see if it's real or not. But I don't know if he knows it, but he's definitely playing with fire in more ways than one. There are a lot of great ways to watch the Young Turks, but is there a best way? Of course, the best way is to watch live. Tune in weekdays, 6 p.m. Eastern, 3 p.m. Pacific. You get our uncensored, unapologetic version of the news that you won't get anywhere else. Watch us live.